Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
It's an ankle injury at this point. I don't know the extent of it, but he'll miss this week. I know that for sure.
And you had Best and you had Picard back on the line. That's how else the line you hope to start the season?
Well, today, you know, it was a reduced type deal. And, you know, Picard, he's one of those guys that you're going to have to fight to hold him out. So, you know, we got a couple of nicks and bruises here and there, and we wanted to see can he go today. So tomorrow will be a full speed day to really see can he go.
Is it time for Chris Best to get back in the starting lineup from what he saw last week?
You know, it's kind of different because he's been at two different positions. But like I said, we have a number of guys that can do a number of good things for us. It may end up that way this week. I'm telling you, don't really think about it as much because I know Chris Sweet does a good job with those guys and they prepare hard.
How do you keep things positive after a four-game losing streak you guys are
in? Well, after a one-game losing streak because it's a six-game season. No, the one thing about it is with these guys, like I tell them, you know, we're in those games. We're in them, and we're close. You know, there's very positives. If you look at the defense, that was very positive. We were in that game all the way to the fourth quarter. The offense did some things. There's a couple of plays that's being left out there, and the biggest thing is showing them that if we make the plays we need to make, then we could easily be on a four-game win streak.
How do you explain the turnaround for Darian? Before, he was hardly turning over the ball, and things have flipped around in this season.
Well, you know, the one thing you look at it, like, you know, I've heard the questions, whether it's from management or whoever, every quarterback in this league has a day. You know, and right now he's going through it. I don't expect it to last. Darian's still positive. He's still upbeat, and he's trying to solve the things himself. It's not like he's putting in any less work. Sometimes that's just the luck of the draw.
So you need to boost from management. What kind of questions from management, and then who from?
No, I mean, you always get questions, you know, whether it's what's, you know, not bad questions. That's what I'm just saying. We all have to answer questions. And when you look at it, like I said, every quarterback in this league is going to have an up-and-down game. You know, do you have to boost Darian's confidence? He's a very confident young man, but he's also the quarterback, and I think you always have to make sure that he has the confidence because he has to play at a high confidence to be a quarterback.
Does the leash get shorter at all?
Well, you know, at the least get shorter for all of us. Darian's doing the right things. Like I said, I don't see anything that needs to be tweaked right now as far as Darian's play. You know, a lot of things may be a misread between he and the receiver. Those are things that we're working on. You know, if I don't want to look at it as a leash. Like I said, I had Darian in this morning. I told him he's still our quarterback and I'm still going to stay with him.
Do you need Drew Willey to get more reps?
Yeah, I need Drew Willey to get more reps in a win, not in a loss.
Why did you feel it was necessary to talk to Darian this morning, just to reaffirm your confidence in him?
Oh, without a doubt. You know, like I said, we're all human. That's the biggest thing, and let him know that, hey, these are the things that we're seeing because this is an evolving team, and we are doing some positive things, you know, and you don't want to ask too much too soon because there are some guys that, you know, they're actually growing. So, you know, we would need some guys that continue to grow to the level that Darian's used to playing at so, you know, he can change some things, you know, do some audibles and do some different things.
The first three wins of the season, did they raise expectations a little higher than maybe what this team was?
Not for me. I mean, the simple thing is we knew we'd have some tough times. And like I told the guys today, if you look across the league in both the East and the West Division, you have two winning teams at the top, and then you have the two losing teams or whatever. And it's only separated besides BC by one game. So, you know, it's one of those things that where the expectations were we wanted to be in the hunt, and I think we're still in the hunt right now.